In addition to uploading the show in its entirety and in an audio podcast version, we are now doing both in segments, so you can watch and listen at your leisure. Hey everybody, welcome back to Rugby Wrap Up. Thanks again for joining us for this latest edition of the Zach Attack with Zach Lanning. Zach, we're going to skip the pleasantries because nobody cares about how we feel. Get right to it. Take it away.
That works for me, Matt. Got a lot to talk about today, so happy to jump right in. I'm just here to focus on two performances I want to spotlight from over the past weekend of Rugby Eagles abroad. Some players from the men's and women's side overseas who just had some really stellar performances for their clubs in the European sides. Starting with AJ McGinty, who's playing fly half for Sale, having a pretty solid season so far, leading the team in points, 121 on the season. He's got one try, 18 conversions, and 28 penalties for a fourth place Sale Sharks side, who are 8-4 currently. This may have been one of his better games of the season so far. They were playing the Newcastle Falcons, and you know, he had 11 points in the game total, but he was facilitating and creating all over the field for his teammates, especially in the first half. He had one play that is going to be, you know, on everybody's mind for a long time. Just a beautiful behind-the-back offload as he was falling into touch to one of his teammates to spring him for a try. A play that he started a few phases earlier with a beautiful skip pass out to the wing. So his director of rugby at Sale, Alex Sanderson, has said that he's in fine fettle this year, which I'm not sure exactly what it means, but I think it sounds like he's having a great year so far, Matt.
Fine fettle indeed. And that pass, that behind-the-back pass, as his feet were in the air before they came down in touch, behind his back, facilitating the try. Wonderful play. And what else you got?
Yeah, so another player who deserves a mention from the weekend is Gabby Cantorna, playing center for the Exeter Chiefs women's, a newly formed side. This is their first season. They have a lot of internationals on their team, but she's one of the standout players for them. Especially this week, she was named, aptly so, the Exeter Chiefs Women's Player of the Day for her performance in a 31-29 win against the Wasps ladies side. She had four conversions on the day, as well as the match-winning penalty, but you may think that was it just to get her that, but it wasn't. She had a try-saving tackle right at the end of the game where she dislodged the ball from a Wasps player to save that lead and hold on to it in the final seconds and give them the win in their first year. They're really rounding into form, and she's joined by a few other really solid Eagles on that squad as well. Kate Zachary, Rachel Johnson, Joanna Kitalinski, and Janine Duncan. A lot of American players on that squad all forming a really, you know, solid core for an Exeter side that's doing their best to you know, run the table in their first year in that competition.
And what about the rumors that the RFU might limit international players? That could really impact the Eagles.
Right. It's been reported that, you know, these are just rumors so far. There's nothing that they've put officially on the table, but the RFU is thinking about their England women's players, and they want to make sure that they're getting, you know, the best treatment. They don't want a flood of international players to come in. But there have been arguments on the other side that are really saying, you know, you want these England players to play against the best, you know, competition around the world. So it would be really unfortunate if they were to cap this number. There really isn't a league that has the same level of talent, you know, and resources anywhere else. So, you know, they're really, it would really hamper some of the, you know, the women in America coming up for, you know, they want to be able to get the same opportunity that Gabby Cantorna and Kate Zachary and the others have at this moment.
All right. If that happens, I'm going to hold you directly responsible, Zach Lanning,
in
your next
fair.
Zach Attack. But thank you, my friend. We are out of time on this week's Zach Attack. Make sure you check out our MLR show with Dan Power and Steve Lewis and a mystery guest, a biggie, and Marshall Law with Colby Marshall. You might have seen the Marshall plant. Well, we've changed it after an extensive marketing search. And please join our American Red Cross Rugby Wrap-Up Blood Donor Team. I know Dan and Steve are going to be signing up because they, too, want to save three lives. On behalf of all these folks, Matt McCarthy, for Rugby Wrap-Up, keep that mouse pad close by.